Tuesday, January 31st, marked the fourth day in the trial against Kareem Martinez for the manslaughter of Laddie Gillett. And while this would be a trying experience for any family to go through, this evening the Bradley Flemings left the courtroom feeling a little lighter.
Today, I mean, I'm satisfied with the testimony, with the witnesses, with the people from the forensic. I must say, I mean, they made the case stronger. They linked him with the case to the area. And today they finished linking him after Sergeant Vasquez testified. One of the questions was, did you fire a shot? And he said, yes. So that gives us more hope that we'll get justice. I think at the day we will get justice. I must say I'm satisfied with the outcome of today.
After yesterday, when we felt so disheartened because we felt the police had done such a bad job, were confused themselves about what they were doing, so we went home very disheartened. Today's a new day, and we felt like the testimonies were very easy to understand, very clear, very well done. So it really gave me pause to reconsider the entire police department, who I was feeling very bad about yesterday. But I must say, today made a huge difference to our case, but to the future, I believe. I was disheartened because I thought, well, is this really what it's all about? But today I saw, no, that's not really what it was about. There were some officers who really weren't doing a good job, and today we had another example of perfect policing. So we were very pleased with today. We feel enriched.
And one of the reasons for that enrichment was the insistence by one of the witnesses, Sergeant Vasquez, that the officers who detained Laddie and Thomas should have been guided by department protocols, even though they weren't.
Yes, there is, but how often do they go through and familiarize themselves, refresh their memory with this guy? That is the question, you know. So you could have everything there in writing, but if you don't practice, if you don't read to know what's there, it's of no use. So I must say that was good that Sergeant brought that out, so that the court and the public could see that there is a manual, there is a guide for police officers when it comes to discharging a firearm.
Emil Bradley himself, a former officer, says that he'll never be able to shake the feeling that what happened to Laddie and Thomas on July 14, 2021, isn't likely to have happened to two teenage white or even Hispanic boys.
Well, one of the problems that we face here in Belize is we like to profile people, you know, and I think that was the situation in this case. I mean, I said, I can't see how come a big security guard of that size, of such nature, with such experience, being an ex-soldier, seeing and you can't identify two youths and you'll feel afraid and say, oh, they're suspicious, just to call the police. It's just because he was scared. He's a coward. That's all I would have to say about him.
Cherise Halsall, 7 News.